another objective of our great party, and that is to promote active involvement from all. One of the things I've always promised you is to listen and then to lead. Your voices have been strong and all your strength. We have crafted a vision to move both our party and our country forward. We have listened to you, and in the coming months, you will hear more of our plans to continue to build our party and our great country. You know, very critical decisions will have to be made, and these decisions will affect the future of our party and the country. These decisions will include decisions to move our party forward to return to office, where we can once again make our homes safe, streets safer, improve health care and education, create more jobs by rebuilding the economy, and we'll do all of this with a drive powered by the innovation and creativity of the people of Trinidad and Tobago. These are the real issues we must all face and fix together. We must set aside the divisions that can blur our focus. And so what is required, as I close, I tell you, what is required is a team which is willing and able to work together for you and for every citizen of the country. It requires a vision and leadership that can marry the youthful ideas together with the solid experience that we need. You would have seen for the local government elections, whilst we kept some of the stalwarts, I brought in a lot of younger persons as councillors and aldermen. Give them a round of applause. In the parliament, I have brought in young, bright persons to marry or to balance with those with greater experience. Give them all a round of applause. I am grateful to every one of you, my UNC family. I am grateful for all those people who are now coming forward, willing to serve our great party. And I want to tell you, finally, this is not about me, as some people would have you believe. I have given my life to service of my country and my party. And so this is about country and our future. This is about a father who fears for the safety of his family, even in his own home, because of the crime. This is about a mother who does not know where the next meal is coming from. This is about a village who is pleading for water. This is about the ailing man who cannot get medication, cannot get proper medical attention at the health institutions. This is about a nation regaining itself, righting itself, resuming its path of progress. This, above all, is a future we owe to our children and grandchildren. And so the poor man and woman who stain their fingers for the ruling regime is reeling from the fact that they perpetrated so willingly with such an unwise volunteer on themselves. I told you earlier, the PNM has a culture of distancing themselves from the common man soon after they are victorious. Their offices become closed, cold, inaccessible to the poor, the vulnerable, and the dispossessed. You talk to those PNM persons. You see them on the TV, you see them on the Facebook, you see them on the blogs, you see them in the parliament and outside the parliament. The contrast with that is our great party. We have always endeavored to be people-centered and to practice servant leadership. We need to start building the economy of the future based on skills and talent. For the future, the technology, the fourth industrial revolution you have heard me speaking of. We have the critical importance of investment in our public services, in health, in education, in our transport system. And here, from talking to people, meeting and hearing them, they may applaud the direction we want to take them, but you know what? They are very impatient. They want to get there as fast as they can. Remove the PNM. That is the mantra. That is the call. The PNM betrayal of the people's trust must end now. The siege must end now. It is time to move on. And I want you to remember something. The political tribalism that once divided us must now give way to nationalism and patriotism. You know why? Because the hunger of the child in Lavantil is the same hunger of the child in Pinal. Yes? The fear of the father for his family's safety in Tobago is the same as that in Toko. The pleas for water in Cedras is the same as that for water in Diego Martin or Mayaro. The cries of a patient for good medical attention in Port of Spain, this man, is the same as it is in Kearney. And so we always say, coming from the famous Shakespearean lines, we are people too. You are people too. And as our good chief servant, Makanda Daga, used to tell us, the people is the government. You remember him? The people is the government. In the last 2 years, we have exposed the incompetence and corruption of the PNM, and they are squarely on the ropes. We have widened and expanded our party's human resources, bringing in more diversity and more youth. You know the UNC is the most diverse party in Trinidad and Tobago. Look at this audience here. Look at this audience here. And they want to tell us that we are tribal. Tell them, go away from here. Is it tribal ones? Is it one who scream race every single day? They are the racist ones. The UNC has room for every creed and every race in our great party. I give you the unconditional assurance today and in the days ahead that I will bend every resource of heart and mind in the days that lie ahead. Tonight, I offer to you, and I tell you, it is my intention to be the candidate as the next servant political leader of the UNC and then your next Prime Minister of Trinidad and Tobago. Our party's constitution asserts our aims and objectives. And these aims and objectives have been my life's work. I propose to defend them and pursue them vigorously, aggressively, with all my courage, with all my vigor, all my might and energy, till the very day I die. I have been in the fields and in the vineyards laboring. I started off in local government. Young local government councillors, take note. Take note, long councillors. I was right there in the St. Patrick County Council. I then served as a senator in the opposition. I then served as an elected member of parliament for this very constituency, East Aparia. I then served as an attorney general, and some may tell me, well, that was the shortest serving AG. But that's okay, I served there. I served as a minister of legal affairs. I served as a minister of education. I served as a deputy leader of this great party. I then served as the political leader of our party, and then opposition leader of our party, and then prime minister of our country. And then I then served as a chair of the 52 Commonwealth nations in the world. And so I assure you, I have the strength, I have the courage, and I want to say to some people, they say, Kamla, you mustn't be afraid of strong people. I am not afraid of any person. I am not afraid of strong people because I have strong people in my Natex, in my House of Representatives, in the Senate, and in this party. How can I be afraid? I have strong people who stand with me night and day. I am not afraid of anyone but my God. The road is never easy. Nothing worth it comes effortlessly. We must put our shoulders to the wheel. With the gaze of one united people, we can overcome. We will triumph. I am UNC and I am proud. Are you UNC? Are you proud? Then I ask you to say with me, I am UNC and I am proud. I am UNC and I am proud. May God bless you. Long live the UNC. Long live Trinidad and Tobago. God bless you and thank you all so much.